with silver trim, trimmed in the U.S. flag. Hailing from Little Rock, Arkansas, he weighed in at a trim and ready 166 pounds. His record 28 wins, 2 losses and 1 draw, with 17 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the 2000 Olympic bronze medalist, the current WBC number 1 ranked contender, and the former undisputed middleweight champion of the world, known as Bad Intentions.
Because he was getting hit with some monstrous punches. And give Carl Froch credit for giving himself distance to punch. He didn't get himself so caught up to get so close to Jermain Taylor that he didn't give himself distance to punch. That was, I think, the key in him ending up stopping Taylor in this fight. And this is the end of the fight, with Ortega looking on very carefully. See, Froch gives himself enough room to punch. He doesn't smother his punches and just keeps punching, and ultimately the fight is stopped. What a dramatic ending, and what an astonishing performance by Carl Froch.
And based on the scorecards, if Jermain Taylor could have stood up and finished the fight, he would have won. Let's go inside the ring, where Jimmy Lennon Jr. is standing by.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 2 minutes 46 seconds in round number 12. Our referee in charge, Michael Ortega, stops the contest. He is the winner by way of spectacular knockout. He is still undefeated and still the WBC super middleweight.